today by the Reserve Bank of India, allowing the digital payment banks increasing the deposit limit to 2 lakhs and also allowing RTGS as well as NEFT payments. What does all of this mean? How incremental is it? Is it significant? Is it a game changer? I'm going to be discussing that and more with one of the big players in this space. It is the top boss of Fino Payments Bank, joining us right here on ET Now. The top boss, Mr. Rishi Gupta. Thank you so much for talking to us. Mr. Gupta, if I could get your reaction first, initial reaction. I know everybody would have wanted this limit of the deposits to be higher, whether 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, but it has been doubled from 1 lakh to 2 lakhs. How big is it?
Thank you, ET. The way I look at it, the industry was asking for definitely at 5 lakh, which is the limit for the insurance, DICGC, so limit was 5 lakhs. We were all requesting if Reserve Bank could look at 5 lakh as the limit in the new shift which has happened. But we are happy to say it's a very welcome move from the regulator to increase the limits from 1 lakh to 2 lakh. I think it's a big change especially from the fact that the operating and the licensing conditions was talking about 1 lakh only. And this is one big significant change which the regulator has done post the issuance of the license in 2017. So I think that's a big move. Personally, I feel it will further enhance the cause of financial inclusion, will give us more flexibility to our customers to keep higher limits with the bank. The entire model for the payments bank will further get enhanced and viable in the long run.
Can you elaborate a bit on that, Mr. Gupta, for the benefit of our viewers, the non-bankers, the ones who may not know the finer details? What exactly do you mean that you need to wait for this check and balance system?
So right now, when you are part of a banking system and you participate in the settlement, you have some kind of guarantee funds, you have some kind of settlement obligations which are there intersea between the banks. Now, when you move to a non-bank entities who will directly have access to the NEFT and RTGS ecosystem, that would mean that some kind of control, some kind of oversight which the regulator might ask, because they are now part of the settlement ecosystem and there is obviously a settlement risk which is there. So like banks are directly regulated and controlled and there is a big oversight over the banking ecosystem by the regulator. I'm assuming that some kind of an oversight or some kind of a maker and checker ecosystem would also come into play when NEFT and RTGS direct settlements is given to non-bank payment companies as well.
The other thing I want to ask you is, all the announcements that have come in today, how is your ecosystem seeing it? You know, for an outsider, it seems as the Reserve Bank is now having more confidence in the digital payments ecosystem, having more confidence in all of you players.
You're absolutely right. Actually, if you look at the direction which the payment and settlement systems have worked in the last 5-7 years, and going by the RBI vision document also, they are opening up the entire payment ecosystem for large players, may not be banks only, but non-bank players as well. So the move like enhancing the limits from 1 lakh to 2 lakh for payments bank is also gives the confidence that RBI is comfortable with the ecosystem. They further looked at enhancing the full KYC PPI limits also from 1 lakh to 2 lakh, which will mean that the full KYC PPI becomes a more mature product, and also cash withdrawal is now allowed under PPI, which was not allowed to non-bank companies earlier. So all this put together along with the direct settlements on the RTGS NEFT gives us to believe that the regulator is becoming more comfortable and wants to open up the ecosystem for banks and non-banks to equally participate. Even the interoperability of wallets, which was announced about 1.5 years back, is now kind of mandated that it has to be completed. So all this ecosystem, whether you look at the full KYC PPI, whether you look at interoperability, whether you look at enhancements of limit from 1 lakh to 2 lakh or cash withdrawal, I think the government is now looking at deepening the financial inclusion and the payment ecosystem in the country. And they don't want to limit it to a few players in the industry. They want to open it up to a larger players, so a bigger digital ecosystem can be created around payments. Because payments is the first platform which any customer would use when they come into any banking domain. We have seen in the same in our case of Fino Payments Bank that our business model largely concentrates on building up the transaction and the payment ecosystem. And over and above that, we keep on adding and cross-selling more products. So I think the collaboration between the fintechs, the banks will further deepen because of the opening up of this ecosystem as shown by the Reserve Bank of India in today's policy.
Mr. Gupta, since I have you here, I have to ask you this. You're talking about how the government has more confidence, the Reserve Bank of India has more confidence. And look at the numbers that have been coming in the last couple of months. Every month, for example, the digital transaction numbers are shattering all kind of records. But there is equally, you know, apprehensions that the infrastructure, whether it is telecommunications or the back end, is just not able to keep up with the burgeoning demand. Has there been improvement on that front, whether it is in the outages, whether it is just to keep up with the infrastructure that is needed?
You're right. Actually, if you look at all payment ecosystems, not only about UPI, but IMPS also, AEPS also, all the BBPS, all ecosystems, even FASTags, you see, all ecosystems have grown leaps and bounds in the last 12 to 24 months. Obviously, the banks and other entities are putting infrastructure to handle the kind of capacities which is there. We have seen some outages which have happened in the recent past also. But I would say this is part of the growing up of the ecosystem. The network, I see, the network is pretty stable now. Obviously, at times we have challenges around connectivity. But I would say that is part of the maturity of the ecosystem which will happen over a period of time. So I'm pretty confident as we as bank in Fino, we work more in the tier 3 to tier 6 kind of territories, and we have seen that the telecom infrastructure is pretty good and it's becoming better by the day. So I don't see that as a challenge. I see the challenge is more in terms of the entire ecosystem ability, not about ability to handle transactions, which will obviously will come over a period of time as people will start putting more infrastructure in the banks and ecosystem, but also a challenge in terms of handling the frauds and the ombudsman and the customer related services. I think that is something which one needs to focus on. Like banks, we have a big ecosystem around customer handling and customer grievances. The same kind of customer handling, customer grievances ecosystem needs to be created for non-banks, because now when we are bringing banks and non-banks together on a single platforms, we need to look at the customer handling part of the ecosystem quite in detail. So that is where I think more focus for banks and non-banks would be to how to handle the customer grievances and related issues.